Now let's move on to the geometry of linear equations. In the coordinate space where you have lines and curves and planes, etc., there is a picture that we already saw where we said equations make lines or planes. A linear equation in two dimension in R2 is a line, and a linear equation in R3 would be, it's a plane. So we talked about that, and we talked about intersections of two lines or two planes or three planes when we tried to visualize the solutions. That is one geometry. It is geometry, but that's not the geometry of linear algebra. So what we did there was to think of each row as an equation and then looked at the geometry of that equation in the coordinate space, the shape of that equation in the coordinate space. And that is really the row picture of equations, because we are going row by row, equation by equation. So if you had common points, then you might have infinity of solutions, or single point of intersection, unique solution, parallel lines, inconsistent equations, etc. There is another one, column picture of equations that would live in vector spaces. What we are saying is that B is a linear combination of the columns of A. The columns of A are vectors in some vector space, and we are trying to find the right linear combination. So the solution would be the coefficients of that right linear combination, which will specify the xi's, and that would be the solution. So this visualization is in terms of the columns of A, so it's called the column picture of equations. But this is a more sophisticated picture because it will lead to a deeper understanding of the structure of solutions, and also it will help you develop better algorithms. Let's look at the row picture. We had two equations, x plus y equal to 5, x minus y equal to 1, and there's an intersection there, a unique solution. This is not the geometry that we're talking about. This is the geometry. I have x plus y equal to 5, x minus y equal to 1. So I have a vector standing here, a red vector and a blue vector. And I'm taking a linear combination because of matrix multiplication. A linear combination of A1 and A2 giving me B. So I have one vector there, the second vector there, and my constants vector standing here. And I want to find the right linear combination of A1 and A2 such that I can get B. So what we would do is to draw a line through the tip of the green vector parallel to my blue vector, and then extend my red vector to hit the blue dotted line. And that scaling will give me the first scaling factor. It turns out that that scaling factor is actually 3. Similarly, through the tip of B, I will draw a line parallel to my red vector, a red dotted line, and I'll extend my blue vector to hit this red line, and that will give me a second scaling factor that turns out to be 2. If I add these dashed bright colored vectors, then I do get my green vector. So that means it's actually a linear combination of A1 and A2 personified in A1 prime and A2 prime. And the scaling factors needed, x is the length of A1 prime by the length of A1. Similarly for A2 also. And then I can see that B is actually xA1 plus yA2, and x and y are the solutions, the right linear combination. So that is the column picture. And I have a plus or minus here, because if I'm scaling in the same direction, it's plus, but if I had to scale it in the opposite direction, it just becomes negative. Now, let's look at, now, if I have inconsistent equations, if I look at the row picture, I have two parallel lines, they never meet. That is one way of looking at it. And if I look at it in the column picture, again I have two columns. Now you can see that they are the same two columns, meaning same numbers there. I'm trying to find x and y such that I get 5, 1 as my b. So what do I have? I have two vectors, a1 and a2. I've shown them slightly separated just so that you can see them, but they are actually right on top of each other. a1 is equal to a2. I'm trying to find a linear combination. So let's follow our construction. I'm going to draw a line, blue dotted line, through the tip of my green vector, and try to extend my red vector to hit the line. It'll never hit the line, so there's no solution there. Similarly, if I try to draw the red dotted line through the tip and try to extend the other one, it'll never find. So I cannot find a solution because the construction doesn't work. So that is just another way of looking at it. It might look a bit unnatural or cumbersome at this point, but it turns out that this is the right geometry that we need to have in linear algebra. Why that is the case will become clearer in two more slides. So if I have three equations with a common solution, this is the coordinate space, row picture, But the column picture becomes something in three dimensions, and we're not going to worry about that. But what I'm really going to worry about is this inconsistent equations. So I have three equations again. They don't have a common point of intersection. So there's no solution. So inconsistency, there's no solution, because if you do the Gaussian elimination, the third equation will read 0 equal to 1. Now, at this point, when we saw this earlier, I said that maybe somewhere inside you have the best possible solution, maybe the centroid, maybe somewhere there. It wasn't clear where it should be. Let's look at the column picture of this one. Now again, I don't want to work in complicated 3D. So let me simplify the last equation by doing the Gaussian elimination so that it reads 0x plus 0y equal to 1. So I have one vector, 1, 1, 0, second vector, 1, minus 1, 0. And I'm trying to find a linear combination of those two so that I get my 5, 1, 1. Which is my constants vector. So let's try our construction again. I have my first vector, second vector. So I'm showing you the xy plane now. A z-axis actually coming out of this plane towards me. So this green vector is not actually on the xy plane. It's actually sticking out by one unit at the tip. So in order to show that, I'm shining light on it from my bright eyes here. And so it casts a shadow on the xy plane. So now you can kind of see that it's actually three-dimensional. Now, my construction is to draw a line through the tip of my green vector parallel to my blue vector and try to extend my vector A1, the red vector, to that line. But it doesn't hit that line because this blue dotted line is not on the xy plane. It's slightly sticking out. So the red vector is going to go underneath it and it's never going to hit the blue line. But it's going to hit the shadow of the blue line because the shadow on the xy plane will intersect the red vector. So there is some point where it might intersect. Not really intersect, but there is some approximate place where it might intersect. Similarly, if I draw a line parallel to my red vector through the tip of my green vector, again, the blue vector is not going to intersect it when I extend it, but it will intersect its shadow, the shadow cast by the red line on the xy plane. And that, you might think of that as the best possible solution. So I'm projecting my green vector onto my xy plane, that is my gray vector there. That is the best possible projection I can have. That is the closest, the tips are the closest. Any other position will be farther away from the tip. And then I can solve because it's already on the xy plane. And that solution might be the best possible solution. So there's a natural way of describing the best possible solution, or the closest you can get to a solution, is actually kind of naturally emerging from our column picture. So this is something to keep in mind. This is the idea of projection onto a different plane and then solving an equation based on the projection, which is actually basically linear regression. That is a machine learning technique, which is a powerful machine learning technique, comes out of this fairly simple picture. Once you start thinking about the equations as columns of the coefficient matrix rather than the rows. So that's the reason why we do the column picture. So the row picture is in the coordinate space, and you have as many dimensions in that coordinate space as you have the variables. So if you have two variables, regardless of how many equations you have, you're working in R2. It looks a little simpler because basically we're working with small number of variables. But when you start working with, say, 50 or 100 variables, the row picture or the column picture wouldn't really make any difference. Both those guys are impossible to visualize. And it turns out that column picture is actually better in terms of linear algebra. So the column picture, the dimension that you're working with is the dimensionality of each column, which is the number of equations. It's m rather than n.